Oh, hello everybody, it's Megalithic here, otherwise known as Pueblo Escobar, and in today's video we'll be taking a look at the True Fade Nero, retailing for a price of $1,440,000, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm sure you'll agree it looks more serious than a tornado warning at a factory for nuclear bombs. Okay, well, let's take it out and see how she handles. This is two fully upgraded True Fade Neros, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to see how they handle. Okay, in terms of acceleration, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, it's going to set off faster than a Puritan pilgrim evading persecution, you know? It really is that quick. In terms of top-end speed, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, I mean, it moves faster than a paedophilic rumor about the royal family. Okay, we're getting down to the cornering here, ladies and gentlemen. The handling's very tight, and I mean, it really is tight. I mean, it's tighter than a baby duck's asshole when it's sat in the snow. Okay, well, we're going to fly along here, and so what can one say about the True Fade Nero, ladies and gentlemen? I mean, you can on this occasion believe the hype, as they say. Acceleration, ladies and gentlemen, is fantastic. Top end speed is fantastic. Handling is fantastic, and so is the traction, you know. This car really is magnificent across the board. It's an absolute delight to drive. Okay, well, that's the standard lap, ladies and gentlemen, completed. We're going to send it on up to Sandy Shores and put it up against some of its other competitors. Okay, well, the very first vehicle we're bringing out, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be the Nero Custom, don't you know? This is a pretty much identical car, except it's had the Bennett's upgrade for about $600,000, so it's taking up to about the $2 million mark. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen, the Nero versus the Nero Custom. As you can see, yeah, significant sort of lurching acceleration towards the top of the track there. More top-end speed than acceleration, I should say. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, so the Nero is sat pretty much in front of it as we come around the corner there. But the Custom, ladies and gentlemen, there is no question, has got that better top-end speed, and yes, comes zooming past us there. So the Custom takes down the Nero, and perhaps that should be no surprise. Okay, so the very next vehicle we're bringing out, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be another True Fade, you know. It is the True Fade Thrax, retailing for $2,325,000, don't you know? It's a very expensive True Fade, ladies and gentlemen, and nearly $1 million more than the Nero. And whilst it has got a better acceleration there, the handling doesn't seem to be as good, ladies and gentlemen. It seems comparable, but the top end speed, ladies and gentlemen, is where it's lacking, you know. So yes, unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, don't spend your money on the True Fade Thrax. That's the truth of it, you know. The Nero is much better. Okay, so the very next vehicle we're going to bring out, ladies and gentlemen, this is a vehicle we don't very often bring out, you know. This is an overflow. This is the Entity XXR, northwards of $2 million once again, ladies and gentlemen. It's $2,305,000, so nearly a full million dollars more. I did get to the top of the track there before us, ladies and gentlemen, but we've got round and round about the same sort of time. There's going to be a battle for it down the back. We're going to see who's got better top-end speed. I'm going to point out all of the other vehicles I've been driven in by Mr. Raccoon. You know, he has a channel of his own. It is called The Bromby, as is his name, The Bromby. If you type that into YouTube, you should be going to find him, when they've got some rather good videos on there. Okay, so it's a Grotti now, ladies and gentlemen, the Grotti Vision, don't you know, once again, retailing northwards of $2 million, $2,250,000. It's was one of the top-end Grottis, ladies and gentlemen. It still is, I suppose, really. It's a very, very fine car, and we're going to see how it stacks up against the Nero at a mere snip at $1,440,000. Okay, there we go. So you can see, ladies and gentlemen, the Nero did pretty much take it to the top there and around the corner, but no, the Vision's got a slightly better top speed, ladies and gentlemen. It's neck and neck pretty much as we cross the line. Okay, there we are. Now we're going to bring out the Progen, ladies and gentlemen. Would you believe bringing out the Progen T20, don't you know? Once again, ladies and gentlemen, northwards of $2 million, $2,200,000. And it really is a very fine car, you know. I mean, not quite as stylish as the Nero, perhaps, you know. I mean, in terms of looks, I mean, the Nero is more menacing than a maniacal mustachioed mercenary with a meat cleaver, let's be quite frank about these things. And as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, once again at $2 million, we're crossing the line and around about the same sort of time. So we're going to start to wrap things up. This is Big Daddy Z, don't you know, the Pegassi Zentorno, $725,000, a very, very good car for its money, ladies and gentlemen. And it's got very good acceleration, as has the Nero. But I mean, the Nero itself, I mean, so in terms of acceleration, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to set you off faster than a rebuke by a convicted fraudster. And in terms of top-end speed, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, it is really fast. I mean, it's faster than a French military retreat, you know. It's just a quick. Okay, and either way, ladies and gentlemen, there is no question it's going to take down the Pegassi Zentorno. We don't see that very often, and my God, how about that? So it really is very fast indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Now there is only one more question. That question is, of course, the final masquerade, the Karate Italia RSX. And if the Nero can take down the Pegassi Zentorno, then maybe I hope he can take down the RSX, but by the time we get halfway up the straight, no, not a chance. So what can we say, ladies and gentlemen? Like I say, I mean, in terms of handling, ladies and gentlemen, it's sharper than a rusty can in a kid's outdoor play area. In terms of looks, it's more brutish than a bare-knuckle boxer from Belfast, ladies and gentlemen. Acceleration, it's going to launch you faster than the failed child safety seat, you know? Top-end speed, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, much like the infamous R&B singer R. Kelly, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to piss all over everything it can. The handling, ladies and gentlemen, as we say, it's more responsive than a horny ex-girlfriend with an Instagram obsession, you know? So should you go and buy it? Both Mr. Raccoon and myself are in agreement, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it's an absolutely fantastic car, but that's not going to stop him from killing me. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching.